morning, Sarah.
Don't forget you have a math test today, and Mom told you to study last night, so she expects you to do well.
Don't worry, Nora.
And there will be consequences. She's thinking of pulling you from soccer if your grades don't improve.
I'll try my best like I always do.
Where do you think you're going?
I'm going to soccer.
Watch out!
Class dismissed. Sarah, I need to see you in the office.
Sarah, I'm astonished. I'm looking at this. This doesn't look like your work. Can you guarantee me that you didn't copy this? Here, you look at it yourself.
Of course I didn't cheat on it. I've never
You really leave me no choice. I might have to bring your mother in, or God forbid, even your sister. How do you explain this?
I think I just did well on it because you're such an amazing teacher and you just helped me learn a lot.
Oh no.
Thank you.
I mean, she's going through things that most three-year-olds should not have to go through, and it's very scary.
He's happy. He's funny. He's pipes.
She has what's called ITP, and it's kind of a rare autoimmune disease that the body attacks the platelets and keeps them super low.
There we go. Come up for you.
Olivia is diagnosed with hepatoblastoma.
Basically a rare form of liver cancer.
He's so fluffy.
Kaya was diagnosed with a rare form of non-Hodgkin's lymphoma called large cell anaplastic lymphoma. Initially, when she was sick, she was treated with high-dose steroids, and she didn't respond. So we opted to kind of just take a watch-and-wait approach.
She was treated with 6 rounds of chemotherapy and a surgery.
Kai is being treated with an intensive chemotherapy. She was like covered with black and blue bruises from head to toe.
I felt a lump in the middle of her stomach, and I thought, gee, I thought I don't remember that with my children.
I remember picking Kaya up underneath her armpits, just like this, and lifting her up, and she shrieked in horror.
I was so scared.
It just took my breath away.
My whole world got completely turned upside down.
Probably for the first month, I was like a basket case.
I just felt completely devastated and helpless.
I was in shock.
You feel like almost like lost, like you're not sure where you're gonna go.
When we got the news that it was malignant, that was probably the most terrifying part of the whole process.
But I felt my job was, as a grandparent, was to be there, to be supportive,
to keep her safe.
My job is to be her rock and to be her support so that she always feels as safe and as comfortable as she can. I think that this is making me a better mom. I understand my role so much more now as a parent, whereas, you know, before we think we need to clothe them and provide the best schools for them and you know, like make sure they have all the things that a child would want. But now I know more than anything, they want to feel safe and they want to feel loved. And I know that so deeply now.
I just was trying to make sure that she didn't run around and bang her head on a table or trip and do something, you know, innocent that a toddler does and hurt herself.
To the people who would want to help but don't know how, I mean, I was one of those people, you know, and just being completely almost ignorant to the world outside of your own. People don't know that the world of sickness even exists because they're living in a very sheltered place.
So for kids, I think the best way to help them would be play, things that interact.
There's the Ronald McDonald House that offers a lot of opportunities for volunteering. There's people that actually volunteer to come play with the children. So when these kids are in the hospital, like we have been for 5-6 days at a time, they're so bored.
Even like going to the playroom at the hospital, spending time with them, it's amazing because it just helps them be normal.
What would I say to a parent or a child going through a similar situation?
I would say hang in there. Hopefully things will get better and
know that you have more to give and that when you think that you don't, you do, and that you are strong enough to get through it.
Keep knocking off the milestones one by one.
I found that prayer was very important and I teach religious ed, and I went there and told the children about Olivia's cancer, and I asked them to help pray and just not to be afraid to believe.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, amen.
It really inspired me to have hope and not to give up.
And know that, you know, with strength you'll get through it.
Hi, I'm Terry. Today I'm trying chips and salsa.
The first salsa we have here today is Tostitos Medium Salsa. The ingredients of this salsa are tomato puree, diced tomatoes and tomato juice, jalapeno peppers, onions, vinegar, salt, natural flavor, and garlic powder. The second salsa we have here today is Old Dutch Medium Salsa. The ingredients of this salsa are diced tomatoes, water, jalapeno peppers, concentrated tomato paste, onions, dehydrated onions, white vinegar, salt, dehydrated garlic, and natural flavor. The third brand of salsa we have today is Newman's Own Medium Chunky. The ingredients of this brand are diced tomatoes, tomato puree, green chili peppers, green bell peppers, onions, red jalapeno peppers, red bell peppers, distilled vinegar, salt, cane sugar, cilantro, garlic, and black pepper.
This is the first salsa.
Thank you. Let's try this out. See, this one's a little bit more liquidy, but it kind of has a small kick to it. I'm gonna do another one of this. Yeah.
This is the second one.
Okay, thank you. Let's try it out. Better actually. Has less liquid and more chunky.
This is a certain one.
Okay, thank you. Try this one out. Now this one's really zesty. And it has, it's way more spicy than the other ones.
Okay, so Tara, which salsa do you think is which?
I think the first one was Tostitos, the second one was Newman's, and the third one was Old Dutch.
You got none of them right. Why do you like salsa?
I like salsa because it has a sweet tomato taste, and I like the chunkiness inside of it. I found that Tostitos was the most spicy, as it had a black pepper taste to it. My favorite would probably be Newman's. I like that one because it had an authentic salsa taste and it had less liquid and more chunky.
Bungalow boy.
Thank you. we're going to April Fool's tomorrow.
Yes.
Yeah, pull prank on someone.
Yeah, but who?
I don't know.
Hey, James.
Hey, James.
Hey.
Sure, this is James' house?
I think so.
Are you sure we're supposed to be here, man?
It's fine, too.
Okay. Someone's robbing his house.
Stop, stop.
Are we good?
I don't know.
What was that?
Oh, oh, April Fools.
Test today, you have 1 hour to complete it. Get to work.
Thank you.
Pinball looks so crazy. I wish I had a ping pong table and somebody to play with.
Whoa, the box actually worked. Let's play. Hey.
Oh, I forgot to eat breakfast this morning. I'm so hungry. Oh, wait. I wish I had a bag of chips.
Sweet.
To someone you don't know.
All right, the band trip is next week.
Please, man, Miss Clogs are gonna kill me. I didn't do the last 5 assignments.
She'll kill both of us if she catches us cheating.
Hey, Matilda, stop talking.
You could have had it done by now if we weren't arguing.
Okay, here you go.
Oh man, Miss Collins is gonna kill us. We're so late.
I know, we at least got the homework done though. I'm screwed, man.
You should have gotten the homework done before you started playing Fortnite. Is this right class?
No one's here.
Oh, I guess we should go back to our homeroom and double check.
Yeah.
Where'd you go, Sam?
Sam? Sam?
If we're gonna do it, it has to be set up tomorrow.
Yeah, we'll set it up then. And then I'll light the match, and then we'll watch it explode.
It's gonna be beautiful.
We can't let anybody know about our plans.
Kaylee.
It's too late, Jake. He's already lit the match.
How could you do this? How could you hurt all those people?
What do you mean, hurt all those people? This is for them to enjoy. I thought they would like it.
And how are they supposed to enjoy it if they're dead?
We're not blowing anyone up. It's supposed to be fun.
I'm getting everyone out
of I'm trying to tell you. No one's gonna die.
So what are you doing then?
Look up. That's what we're doing. It was for student council, a fundraiser thing. No one was gonna get hurt.
You feel so stupid. Why didn't you just tell me?
I tried to tell you, but you wouldn't listen to me.
Thank you.
All right, class, in a week from today, we will be having our unit test.
This test is going to be so easy. I'll get the best mark of the class. Guaranteed.
In your dreams, little boy, obviously it's gonna be me.
Wanna bet?
Fine. Whoever gets the highest mark in the class gets $100.
Hey, what were you guys talking about?
The test.
Oh, cool. Do either of you want to study for it with me?
No thanks. We have money on the line. I'd rather not study with you.
Yeah, this is serious now. I will not waste my time.
Oh, okay.
Thank you.
good luck.
You too, you'll need it.
Delivered Mr. Wilbury's newspaper to us. Could you run it over to him, please? It's by the front door.
Do I have to?
It'll just take a minute.
Come on in. It's unlocked.
Here, Mr. Wilbury. I have your paper.
Why, thank you. But call me Victor. None of this Mr. Wilbury formality. I haven't seen you since my wife died.
Well, I have to be going now.
No. Stay and have a cup of tea. Go into the kitchen and get yourself a mug. Take a seat there, dear. I'll pour you some tea. You know, I was thinking. Today would have been my mother's birthday. Really remarkable woman she was. Raised me and all my siblings. I herself. I'll still remember what she said the day I asked her where my father was.
I guess it is about time I told you, son. Your father? Well, he left us when you were about a year old. I came home one day and there was a note on my bed explaining that he had met some young jazz singer and that he was leaving me for her. It was about the hardest thing that ever happened to me. But you know, I don't regret it, because if I hadn't met that miserable excuse for a man, I wouldn't have had you. Things happen for a reason, good things and bad. They're all leading somewhere.
Say, why are you delivering my paper? Is this your paper route now?
They accidentally delivered it to my house instead of yours. And I don't think kids do paper routes anymore.
Really? No more paper routes. Do you have a job?
No, I'm 15.
15, hey? I had a job when I was 14, working on the railroad. Back in my day, everybody my age had a job. I worked on the railroads for a year. I'd had pneumonia when I was a child. My health was never really the same. So I found a job that was easier on my lungs. Splitting wood for the lumber mill. There's something almost meditative about splitting wood. Just me, the forest, and my axe. Then I had the accident. Ah! Would you like some more tea, dear?
Oh, that's okay. I have lots. What did you do after you wrecked your foot?
Well, it was the 50s, so of course I started a plant business.
Why a plant business?
Do you mean to tell me you never heard of the 1950s plant boom?
No.
My word, they teach you nothing in school nowadays. The 50s is the first time people started buying plants for the sake of owning plants. Just to look at. My friend and neighbor Victor Remington was the distant cousin of some earl or count in Bulgaria, and he used his inheritance to help us get our plant business up and running. Victor and Victor's Botanicals was extremely successful, but more importantly, that's where I met Mildred. This girl was at the stand to buy an orchid. She was the most beautiful woman in the world. I knew right then that she was the woman I was going to marry.
And did you marry her?
Yes, I did. You know, she looked after you sometimes when you were younger. A couple years later, Remington went off to war, and he never came back. I was too sad to continue without him, so I closed Victor and Victor's Botanicals. Fortunately, I had enough money to support Mildred and myself, and when we got married, we moved here. I'll never love anyone as much as I loved her.
It was really nice talking to you, Mr. Wilbury. I mean, Victor, but I have to get going. Thank you for the story.
No, dear. I always tell anybody who's willing to listen. I believe my mother now. Everything does happen for a reason. Life pushes and pulls you in different directions. If I hadn't got pneumonia, I would have never worked for the lumber mill. I would have never sliced my foot open. Victor and Victor's Botanicals would have never existed. I would have never met my wife. The world sure is a different place now. Children don't study the 1950s plant boom or have paper routes anymore. People are all caught up in the future. They forget that every little thing matters, and it's all leading somewhere.